today we are going to talk about the MCP server for the community sample gallery that we created. I'm Paolo and I'm a senior developer advocate in Microsoft. So as you were telling us, Visa, what is an MCP? What is MCP and what is an MCP server? Well, MCP stands for the Model Context Protocol. And it is an open source standard created by Anthropic, which can be used to connect AI applications to other systems and services. And there is a really nice metaphor that you can use to describe MCP, which is describing MCP like a universal plug or like a USB-C connector that you can use to connect your device to any other device. That's the overall idea, but applied to the AI world. So, by using MCP, you can create agents which can call external services and systems in a really smart way based on the description of the functionalities provided by those external services and relying on the LLM intelligence and capabilities to determine which is the right MCP server to use and to invoke to do something or to get some data or to get specific prompts. And by using MCP, developers can definitely save time and make better AI-based solutions. Just to give you a better understanding of what MCP is, I created a diagram that you can use to better understand how the architecture of MCP works. So imagine that you have an MCP host, which generally speaking could be Copilot, could be GitHub Copilot, any IDE of your choice, a chat UI or whatever else is relying on AI, and which is also using an LLM, so a model, a foundational model, and an orchestrator. And you have an MCP client, which is actually the component in the MCP host, which will take care of consuming an MCP server. How? Well, the MCP client will discover and connect to the MCP servers. You will have one MCP client for every single MCP server you want to consume from your agent. And the MCP client will be able to invoke the tools, query resources, and discover and the prompts provided by the MCP server. On the other side, there will be the MCP server, which will provide tools, which are nothing more than functions that your LLM can invoke. Resources, which are data sources provided as read-only information by MCP server, and prompts, which are pre-built instructions that you can use to work with the specific tools and resources that you have available through the MCP server. On a connection, on a connectivity point of view, on a transport point of view, whenever you consume an MCP server, you can either use the standard I/O protocol when the MCP server is running locally on your environment, or you can use the streamable HTTP when the MCP server is a remote one. And under the cover, the protocol that is used on the wire is the JSON RPC 2.0. Okay. From an authentication point of view, you can have anonymous MCP servers, you can rely on API keys or on open authorization 2.0. Okay, so this is the big picture of what MCP is. Now, just to let you know, Microsoft loves MCP, and you can clearly see that because in Microsoft, we are providing support for MCP in many, many ways. Of course, as I said, Anthropic is the company who created the Model Context Protocol, but on the Microsoft side, we have plenty of MCP hosts like Visual Studio Code, Visual Studio, GitHub Copilot, and many more. We have plenty of tools available and supported by all of these MCP hosts through the MCP client that we provide. And we can also create MCP servers using, for example, the MCP SDK for C#, or relying on the Azure API management, or creating Azure functions, and so on and so forth. So plenty of options for you to leverage MCP and to create your own MCP servers. And that's why, from a community point of view, I decided to create the MCP server for the community sample gallery, which is right now providing four different tools. One is the sample by keyword, as you can argue from the name. You can use it to search for samples in the community gallery by providing a specific keyword to search for. Or you can use the sample by product, and you will search by product indeed, or sample by author, if you are interested in all of the samples created by a specific author. And then you have the search samples tool, which will require a complex JSON input, and which will give you an open search model across all of the content that we have in the community sample gallery. I created this MCP server using the MCP SDK for C Sharp, and it is provided in two different versions. Sorry about that. We have the standard IO one and the streamable HTTP one. It is open source indeed, because we are a community and sharing is caring. So the whole source code is available at the AKMS URL that you see right here. And we also have a public endpoint so that if you simply want to play with the MCP server for the community sample gallery and you don't want to host it on your own resources or on your own machine, you can simply target the endpoint that you see here. Not really a friendly one, but you can still copy and paste the URL. And I'm right now writing all of these URLs in the chat so that you can rely on them. So that said, let's move to the actual demo. Let me show you how I build the MCP server and how you can leverage this MCP server in your real life. So let's start from the basics. Here is the sample solution gallery where, as we said, we can find up to 2,500 samples. And here is the repository on GitHub where you can find the source code of the MCP server for the gallery. And here you can find examples and information about the server itself. But what I want to do right now is to use the MCP inspector, which is a really useful tool that you can use to inspect the functionalities provided by an MCP server. So I'm going to connect to the public endpoint of the MCP server for the gallery. Let me select connect. And now that I'm connected, I can simply list all of the tools provided, made available by the server. And as you can see, I was not lying. These are the four tools that we provide right now. And you can, for example, search by product. So if I select this tool, I can say that I want to search samples about SharePoint. I want to get page number one and the very first 10 items in the first page. I can run the tool. And I can get back as a JSON response the list of samples available, the very first 10 samples available in the sample gallery about SharePoint, where the product, as you can see, is SharePoint or maybe SharePoint and something else. And you can do that, and you can play with the MCP inspector as like as you want, using all of the tools that we have available. But what makes this really interesting is that you can actually use the MCP server also in MCP hosts, like, for example, GitHub Copilot. So let me switch to Visual Studio Code. Here I have GitHub Copilot in agent mode, and here I can start playing with our MCP server to do really nice stuff. So for example, if I select the configure tools option, we can see that right here, I already have the MCP server for the sample gallery configured with all of the tools that I showed you before. So we can do stuff like, for example, we can say, I don't know, let's say that I want to search for the samples that I have in the sample gallery where the author is myself, so why not? So let's provide this prompt to the GitHub Copilot agent mode, and it will actually consume the MCP server that I showed you before. And as you can see here, we can see it is going to send this request with the page size of 20, first page, author Paolo Pia. I'm okay. I'm okay to send this request to the MCP server. So let's see what happens now. As you will see, now the agent is able to consume the response provided by the MCP server, and will list all of the samples, also divided by categories and with other useful information, which have been processed by the LLM. So from an MCP server perspective, we simply provide a JSON array of samples, but it is the LLM that it is processing the output and giving a nice looking response to the user. And that's really cool. And then, of course, you can dig into a specific sample, get additional information and stuff like that. But you can even do more. Let's say that you are a maker or a developer willing to create a solution with Copilot Studio. Well, nowadays with Copilot Studio, you can easily consume an MCP server. So here I have an agent that I already created in Copilot Studio. This is a very simple one, but in the Tools tab, I have the MCP Sample Gallery tool pre-configured. How can I do that? You add a tool, you select to create a new tool of type Model Context Protocol, you provide a name and a description, the URL of the server, and the authentication technique you want to use. Once you hit create and you connect, you will be able to get and yes, I want to leave because I already have it, you will be able to get all of the information about the MCP server that you want to consume. Now we are doing the discovery of all of the tools available. And here again, and one more time, you can see that I have these tools available. And again, it's like as before, I can, for example, say that I want to search something through this agent. But this agent is actually made available not only in Copilot Studio itself, but also in the Microsoft 365 Copilot chat. In fact, after publishing this agent, I made it available through the Teams and Microsoft 365 Copilot channel, which means that I can go to the Copilot chat. Here I have my sample gallery agent, and I can search for stuff like, for example, search the very first 10 samples about Microsoft Copilot. Or I can even do more. I can say, okay, search for the very first 10 samples, but give me title, description, author, GitHub URL of the sample, and preview image. Let's see what happens now. Now, the agent that I created with Copilot Studio will again consume the external MCP server, will determine which is the best MCP tool to use to give me the answer I'm looking for, and will retrieve the information and build the output, the response for the user, based on the input that I provided in the prompt. So I will get title, description, author, GitHub URL, and preview image. And the preview image should come shortly, hopefully. And you will be able to see, and here it is, you will be able to see that we can retrieve really useful information to navigate and to inspect the content of the sample gallery through an agent-like experience, which is, again, in my opinion, really, really cool. But when I introduced the MCP and the MCP theory, I said that on the wire layer, we have JSON RPC 2. So let me prove it, because usually when I say something, I want to give you the evidence of that. So let me switch to Bruno. Actually, we don't talk about Bruno, we just use it. That's a bad, dead joke. Sorry about that. But this is Bruno, a tool to make HTTP calls and to expect HTTP traffic, sorry. My voice is going away today. Sorry about that. And here in Bruno, we can make, for example, a request for the MCP server that I'm actually running in Visual Studio Code right here, because my MCP server is nothing more than a .NET application where I'm using and I'm relying on the Model Context Protocol NuGet package and the additional NuGet package for ASP.NET Core, and in the program CS, where I create the settings for my services, I simply add the MCP server with HTTP transport, and I will dynamically read from my assembly all of the tools available and declared in my solution. Plus, I add an HTTP client for the sample tools, which is the actual HTTP client that I'm going to use to consume a REST API, which is provided by the sample gallery. So in the sampletools.cs file, I declare that I have an MCP server tool type, and this attribute comes from the Model Context Protocol NuGet package. So I declare that this class, is the one representing a type which will make available one or more tools. And then inside this class, I have all of the business logic to invoke the REST APIs of the sample gallery and to provide every single tool, like the sample by product, which is an MCP server tool, yet another attribute provided by the Model Context Protocol NuGet package. This is the description that is applied to this specific tool. And then we also have the tool to search by author, the tool to search by keyword, and last but not least, the tool to search the whole sample gallery, providing a complex search query, where the complex search query is a complex type with the name search samples that I defined in my models and which declares how a search is made. So for example, I can say that when I want to search the samples, I need to provide the sorting criteria, the filtering criteria, pagination, and stuff like that. And so back to Bruno, I can use RPC, JSON RPC. I can initialize the conversation. I can list all of the tools available, and I can make a call for the search samples tool, providing that I want to search for myself, sorting the output by title, And I can simply send this HTTP request and get back. This is not looking nice, but it is actually the JSON response with the list of samples that I created and sorted by title. So this is really, really interesting, in my opinion, because you can dig into the source code and learn how to create an MCP server, and you can play with the example gallery and with the samples that we have in the sample gallery. Few useful links, and thank you so much.